ओके, गुड मॉर्निंग वन एंड ऑल। ओके, सो वाइस, अच्छा, दिस इज द सेकेंडरी एजुकेशन वी आर सपोज टू स्टडी, एंड द सेकेंडरी एजुकेशन कमीशन वाज अपॉइंटेड इन 1952 एंड दे हैव सबमिटेड इट्स रिपोर्ट इन 1953, एंड इट वाज the commission was in the chairmanship of Dr. A. Lakshman Swami Muddalayar. I think all those things you know. He was then the vice chancellor of Madras University. Okay, and that's why popularly we used to say that the Muddalayar Commission. But the proper name of this commission was the Secondary Education Commission. Before proceeding, I will like to know from you, because this is the topic which is discussed in general, but here we have to discuss specifically the recommendations based on the secondary education and specifically its aim, objective, structure and the evaluation when you will see the syllabus. So I will like to know from you that till now, from the discussion over the secondary education, what you have learnt from those discussion? Can you tell in one or two sentence or within a minute kind of a thing? Anybody? Can anybody say that what was the major recommendation, major base of the secondary education commission? Anybody?
Sir, just like vocational education was gradually improved.
Achha.
By time to time.
Okay. Vocational education was emphasized. Yes.
Then the political influence is also there.
Political influence was also there. What kind of a political influence?
So,
I am talking about the recommendations of secondary education, Suryakant.
Okay. So then vocational education and science, emphasis on science and mathematics according to their needs.
Achha. Yes, Biswajit. Biswajita, I think she want to say something.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Ah.
Yes, sir. Sir, mainly recommends about the vocational training. You know, like Suryaka, sorry, jo Suryakant ne bola. And uske baad bhi secondary education also talks about the that the secondary education act as the link in between primary and higher education.
Okay.
And also 2 years of teacher training or teacher education. It okay. also says upon this, and also. Like accommodation and scholarship programs for the teacher educators.
Okay.
In service training के ऊपर भी कुछ बोला.
बोला सब में बोल दिया. अच्छा.
ओके. रिक्त सर कोर्स के बारे.
हाँ बोलो बोलो बोलो. रिक्त
सर कोर्स के बारे में.
रिफ्रेशर कोर्स के बारे में भी बोला.
हेलो सर,
व्हाट्सएप सेमिनार ये सब भी चाहिए.
हाँ, यस दामोदर,
इन सर्विस टीचर.
हाँ, कंटिन्यू.
यस सर, गुड मॉर्निंग सर.
दामोदर दामोदर, लेट द विश्वजीता फिनिश, देन यू विल स्पीक. ओके. हाँ विश्वजीता, कंप्लीट.
ओके सर. ओके सर,
कंप्लीट योर. विश्वजीता, हैव यू कंप्लीटेड?
यस सर. यस सर, वॉइस ऑफ. ये सर वही सब बोला, इन सर्विस टीचर ट्रेनिंग कोर्स के बारे में बोला, वो फ्री ऑफ कॉस्ट होना चाहिए.
ओके दामोदर.
Yes, sir. As you said that speaking in any two lines, so I just learned about this all this secondary education period that we learned about earlier time and the map of earlier time secondary education and after independence the secondary education that co what are the commissions we got there, like Chartered Act we got there, where manpower emphasis was there. Similarly, gradually it emphasized by religion-based, like Christianity, missionary education, it's emphasized. Then gradually it overcome to as per the means recent trend demanding that it turned to as secularism, then religion-based, that kind of secondary education. It's gradually improved as per the Western type of demanding, which I learned.
Okay, so one response I have got in the chat box also from the Smarnika Dalai. The duration of secondary education should be 7 years and it should cover the age group of 11 to 17 years. Yes, very much right. So, in this session, in the third semester, again we have to study about the secondary education. And the emphasis is on the aim, organization, curriculum, and the evaluation. Specifically to that thing we have to discuss. So again, we will go with the initial means that those things we will discuss very briefly, and we will discuss in detail what is the what was the aim and other things. Okay. So when we see the Secondary Education Commission, it was appointed by the Government of India based on the 5 major objective. Because when we have a educational commission, before appointing any commission, not only for the commission for the education or a commission for the any kind of thing, any commission or a committee when it is appointed by the Government of India, they have a some objective. Means what kind of recommendation, what kind of work they want to be done by the members of a commission. So they have pinpointed 5 objectives, that is known as the terms of a reference. Okay, don't write all those things. We will I will supply you all. ठीक है, ये सब लिखने में मैं बोलूँगा, आप लिखेंगे तो I don't think that you will be able to write also. ठीक है, मैं नहीं भी दूंगा ना तो सेकेंडरी एजुकेशन कमीशन का तो मैं पूरा रिपोर्ट आपको दे दिया हूँ, उसमें टर्म्स ऑफ रेफरेंस सब दिया हुआ है उसमें. ठीक है, और द ब्यूटीफुल थिंग ऑफ दिस कमिटी रिपोर्ट, व्हाट डू यू नो व्हाट इज दैट? दैट इज द ब्यूटी ऑफ द मेंबर्स ऑफ दिस कमिटी. पूरा कहानी लिखने के बाद दे हैव आई थिंक 14 और 15 चैप्टर दे हैव. ओके, सो विद इन दैट 14 एंड 15 चैप्टर, one chapter में one thing they have discussed, and at the end 4-5 point में conclusion of the chapter they have given. So if you are not interested to read the 400-500 page, obviously it is not possible. I will not expect from you also, because एक एक जो document है 400-500 page का है. So if I will tell you to go through the 3-4-5 commission committee report, it will just understand how much use it will be. But beauty of this report is that at the end of every chapter they have concluded in the point, 4-5 point hai. So 4-5 point ko aap padh lenge, likh lenge, that will be sufficient enough for you. Theek hai, to ye bahut acha sa documented hai ye document. So when we talk about the terms of a reference of this commission, they are based upon the first term of a reference was to inquire the present position, as in the previous semester also I have discussed, and it is a very much essential also, because if you are having given a task of recommending something, so obviously your recommendation should start with the study of the present situation. What is the present situation of a secondary education in the country? And so this was the first of the term of reference of this committee. Means you have to study the present situation of a secondary education in India, and then you have to report it. The second was suggest regarding the aim, organization, content of the secondary education in the country. Very specific task they have given. You have to give the recommendation on the basis of what should be the aim of a secondary education. Okay. So, you have to take that point. What should be the aim? For what aim we should organize a secondary education? What should be the organizational structure? As you know that earlier we were having the 10 plus 2 structure. Now, it is replaced by the 5 plus 3 plus 3 plus 4 structure. Earlier, there was some other structure also, that also we will discuss. And this committee was also some suggesting some other structure, means that structure was before the 10 plus 2. So, they have been asked that what should be the structure of the committee and the the structure of the secondary school. What should be the content, what kind of a content should be taught, what kind of a subject, what kind of the curricular area should be emphasized, as you were saying that Biswajita was saying that, and the Suryakant also said that vocational education was emphasized. That is a part of the content part. Okay. And what should be the that the evaluation strategy of the during the secondary education. But the beauty of this commission report is that they have looked into this matter along with the some other matters also. They have suggested a lot of a thing in a very precise and comprehensive manner related to the secondary education only, because this is related to only secondary education. The next thing was suggest regarding the relationship of a secondary education with the primary education and the higher education. See how beautifully the link they have given, because secondary education comes in between the primary education and the higher education, and we know that secondary education makes a bridge, it is a link between the school education, elementary education and the higher education. So, they have been also given a task of suggesting the relationship, what kind of a relationship is there and how it should be strengthened, because if we will find that the content and the pedagogical aspect of a secondary education is delinked from the elementary education, then also it will be harmful. If we will find that the content of a secondary education and the content of higher education is delinked from the higher education and a secondary education, then also it will be problematic. So, they have looked into this matter and they were actually supposed to look into that. The next thing was suggest regarding the interrelationship of a secondary school of a different type of a secondary school that was existing, that they were supposed to study and suggest the interrelationship, different type of secondary school like that. secondary part was covered in a special secondary schools like that, the high school. Some of the school were having the elementary school and the secondary school as well, as in some part of the country the 11 and 12 was a part of the university system and it was known as an intermediate, somewhere it was some other nomenclature also. So, they have to given a task into look into that manner also. Okay. So, these were that the terms of a reference of the committee. Okay. So, means they were supposed to look into these things. Now come to the some of the identified area that was looking for immediate attention as per the commission, because the commission had identified some of the area that was requiring a immediate attention for the qualitative and a quantitative improvement of the secondary education. So, what was those thing which was pointed out by the commission? First, they pointed out that the education in our school is in the isolated from the life, and the curriculum as a formulated and is prescribed through the transactional method of a teaching does not give the student insight into the everyday's life in which they are living. Means the content and the transactional process that is in the school, whether it is in the elementary school or a secondary school, it is not very much linked with the day-to-day life of the child. The content is something else, the child is experiencing something else. The transactional modality is a something else, and the world the child is seeing is a something else. And that is why the child is delinked from the child was feeling delinked from the content they are studying, and they were unable to find this or establish the linkage of the content learned in their life, the relevance of the content learned in their life. So, that was requiring an immediate attention, and that needs to be taken care as per the commission. The second thing that they have pointed out, it is narrow and one-sided and fails to train the whole personality of the student. Narrow and one-sided means there was a more emphasis, or you can say that almost all the emphasis for the curricular part, but the personality development, the interest of the child was not taken care, and it was not nurtured even. For sake of example, if I am interested in the game and a sport, if I am interested in the dance and music, if I am interested in the literary activity, that was not taken care, and that was not nurtured. The third thing they have pointed out that was requiring an immediate attention, that the teaching was generally practiced failed to develop the student their independence of thought and initiate in action. Means whatever the teaching learning process was there, it was based upon the rote learning process. Whatever I am saying, you have to remember and reproduce in the examination. That was the teaching learning process. Means there was a not ample opportunity for the creative thinking, critical thinking, developing the problem solving abilities, all those things was not very much emphasized. And we know that in order to have a holistic development, these things needs to be emphasized. So, that was the another thing that was requiring a immediate attention. The next thing was the method of a teaching the next thing was increase in the size of a class has considerably reduced personal contact between teacher and a pupil. So, the classroom was a big in size. Suppose that one teacher is handling a classroom size of 100 student, 80 student, 70 student, or sometime it was more than that also. So, the personal relationship between the teacher and a student was lacking, and in absence of the personal relation between teacher and a student, the personal touch, the emotional touch, the understanding the child process was not going on, and that is why it was not very much child friendly. Because in order to make a teaching learning process child friendly, we must understand the child, but the scope of understanding the child was very less. And it also point out that the training of a character and inculcation of a proper discipline has been seriously undermined because there is a less scope of face to face interaction, personal interaction. So obviously these things were hampered. And the last point that I will say in this series, that the weight of examination had tended to curb the teacher initiative to stereotype of a curriculum to promote mechanical and lifeless method of a teaching. And it has also discouraged the spirit of experimentation and placed the stress on the wrong. So, the point of saying that the evaluation system, examination system was so rude, it was having the less scope of expressing the child, as I have told that you have to remember and you have to reproduce, and the basically at that time the examination system was annually, so there was a less scope of assessing the child, understanding the child throughout the year to, and there was a less scope of know their progress throughout the year, and there was major emphasis on the subjective kind of testing item. Subjectivity was more, experimentation was less. So, it was a totally rotten modality of assessment and evaluation. So, these thing, these five thing was identified by the Secondary Education Commission. And based upon the task they have been given, and they have identified these five things, and their whole document, when you will find, their whole document is based upon these five parameters only, because they have identified these things. So, obviously, their document is based upon how we can improve this situation, like a teaching learning modality, like a curriculum part, like a assessment and evaluation part, like the linking from the life to the content, like the linking the elementary to the secondary, secondary to the higher education. So, this is based upon these things only. So, here we will have a small question answer session, so that we will know that if you have any kind of a clarification or a doubt at this part, we will clarify, and then we will move towards the what were the recommendation of the commission regarding the aim of a secondary education. Okay. Do you have any question? Yes. Devasis, do you have any question?
Yes, sir.
हाँ, तो मैं तो कब से पूछ रहा हूँ कि question पूछिए. I have to call the name.
तो सर question नहीं.
अच्छा, क्या है? बोलिए. आप तो साधु बाबा जैसा लग रहे हैं आज. I understand कि अभी बाल काटने में problem है थोड़ा. Even I am also not going for the haircut. बट ये सब ना थोड़ा घर में ट्रिम कर सकते हैं
सर. ट्रिम नहीं है घर में.
ट्रिमर नहीं है घर में?
नहीं है सर.
अच्छा, ओके 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 ओके, चलो कोई बात नहीं. द मदर इज स्माइलिंग, आई थिंक ही विल परचेज वन ट्रिमर फॉर यू. अच्छा ठीक है, व्हाट वाज दैट, आस्क मी.
हेलो.
हाँ यस प्लीज, आई एम वेटिंग फॉर यू प्लीज.
हेलो.
हाँ हाँ
सर, सर आपने जो बोले कि एम ऑफ एजुकेशन कंटेंट इन द कंट्री, देन बोले कि नीड टू क्वालिटेटिव एंड क्वांटिटेटिव डेवलपमेंट हो सर, उसका एक एग्जांपल देने से थोड़ा
अच्छा, क्वांटिटेटिव एंड क्वांटिटेटिव एंड क्वालिटेटिव डेवलपमेंट। क्वांटिटेटिव डेवलपमेंट बोलते हैं कि
नेक्स्ट।
क्वांटिटेटिव डेवलपमेंट बोलते हैं कि मोर स्कूल विल बी ओपन्ड विथ सेकेंडरी एजुकेशन, है ना, रीच स्प्रेड करना है, बिकॉज इफ द नंबर ऑफ अ सेकेंडरी एजुकेशन स्कूल विल बी लेस, देन ऑब्वियसली इट विल रीच टू द लेस स्टूडेंट, है ना। सपोज दैट मान लिया जाए कि भुवनेश्वर में ओनली टू सेकेंडरी स्कूल्स आर देयर, सो ऑब्वियसली द रीच ऑफ द स्कूल टू द चिल्ड्रेन विल बी लेस, एंड इफ वी विल ओपन द सेकेंडरी एजुकेशन स्कूल इन एवरी पार्ट ऑफ द भुवनेश्वर, सो ऑब्वियसली मोर चिल्ड्रेन विल बी एबल टू रीच टू द सेकेंडरी स्कूल, दैट इज द क्वांटिटेटिव इम्प्रूवमेंट, मीन मोर स्कूल विल बी ओपन्ड। ओके, क्वांटिटेटिव इम्प्रूवमेंट बोलते हैं कि द टीचिंग लर्निंग प्रोसेस विल बी इम्प्रूव्ड, पेडागॉजी, देन कैरिकुलम, देन मेथड ऑफ असेसमेंट, देन लिंकिंग इट टू द चाइल्ड्स लाइफ, है ना, दीज आर द क्वांटिटेटिव इम्प्रूवमेंट, सॉरी क्वालिटेटिव इम्प्रूवमेंट, है ना। क्वालिटेटिव इम्प्रूवमेंट मीन्स हाउ वी कैन इम्प्रूव द टीचिंग लर्निंग सिचुएशन एट अ सेकेंडरी लेवल, एंड क्वांटिटेटिव इम्प्रूवमेंट इज हाउ वी कैन स्प्रेड द रीच ऑफ सेकेंडरी एजुकेशन टू ऑल स्टूडेंट, है ना, दिस इज द क्वांटिटेटिव एंड क्वालिटेटिव। ओके
ये सर, ये हम जब इसको समराइज करते हैं इसका मतलब है कि क्वांटिटेटिव जो है उसको स्कूल ओपन के मतलब मैक्सिमम स्कूल ओपन से रिलेटेड है, और क्वालिटेटिव टीचर को ऊपर डिपेंड करता है ज्यादा।
ना ना, क्वालिटेटिव विल डिपेंड ऑन टीचर, इट इज राइट, बट नॉट ओनली इन टीचर। सपोज दैट वी हैव टू फ्रेम द कैरिकुलम बेस्ड अपॉन द सोसाइटल नीड, बेस्ड अपॉन द चाइल्ड्स नीड, सो फ्रेमिंग द कैरिकुलम इज नॉट अ ड्यूटी ऑफ अ टीचर, दे विल कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट इन दैट, बट इट इज अ ड्यूटी ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट और द एजेंसी कंसर्न, लाइक द एनसीईआरटी इज द वन ऑफ द एजेंसी, एससीईआरटी इन ओरिसा वी हैव अ टीई एंड एससीईआरटी, टीचर एजुकेशन एंड एससीईआरटी, दे आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर फ्रेमिंग द कैरिकुलम, डेवलपिंग अ टेक्स्ट बुक, सो टीचर इज अ वन पार्ट इन अ क्वालिटेटिव इम्प्रूवमेंट, बट अदर स्टेक होल्डर्स आर ऑल्सो देयर। सपोज दैट यू हैव टू टेक अ पॉलिसी लेवल डिसीजन ऑन असेसमेंट प्रैक्टिसेस, सो अलोन टीचर कैन नॉट डू, है ना, टीचर हैव देयर लिमिटेशन बिकॉज दे हैव टू गो विद द पॉलिसी रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशन, सो पॉलिसी हु विल फ्रेम, द गवर्नमेंट or the concerned authority. Okay, so these constitute the part of the qualitative improvement. Alone teacher is not there, but teacher is a part, obviously teacher is a part, but apart from the teacher there are some others also. Okay, yes
sir, mera ek doubt hai jo NCERT ke bare mein.
Haan, pucho Suryakant.
जैसे कि एनसीआरटी मतलब वहां पे जो है, मतलब हु आर द पीपल्स पीपल्स दे आर कंडक्टिंग एनसीआरटी, मतलब व्हाट व्हाट काइंड ऑफ एजुकेशन दे हैव टू रीच देयर, जैसे कि करिकुलम कंस्ट्रक्ट करते हैं मतलब वो कौन
अच्छा
लोग हैं,
एंड दे हैव अ रिक्रूटमेंट प्रोसेस एंड दे हैव अ क्राइटेरिया फॉर रिक्रूटमेंट एंड दे आर बींग रिक्रूटेड, अभी रिक्रूटमेंट आया हुआ है एनसीईआरटी का, वेबसाइट में डाउनलोड कर लो, देन यू विल फाइंड दैट व्हाट इज द एजुकेशनल क्वालिफिकेशन रिक्वायर्ड फॉर द रिक्रूटमेंट। सपोज दैट व्हेन यू विल टॉक अबाउट द कैरिकुलम, मैं मेरे पास है, रुक जाओ मैं पढ़ के सुना देता हूँ। अभी मेरे हाथ में ही है, देखो इधर है, मैं अप्लाई कर रहा था ना, फॉर्म भर रहा था, तो मैं ऐसे प्रिंट करके रखा, देखो एप्लीकेशन इतना मोटा पेज में है, 42 पेजेस है ऐसे, ठीक है। जैसे मैं तुमको बता देता हूँ, एक एक पढ़ के बता दूंगा, ज़्यादा बेटर रहेगा। कैरिकुलम के लिए कहाँ गया कैरिकुलम, हाँ कैरिकुलम से ही स्टार्ट करते हैं, 3.14। सी इफ यू वॉन्ट टू बी अ फैकल्टी इन द कैरिकुलम, यहाँ दे हैव अ पोस्ट कैरिकुलम डेवलपमेंट रिसर्च एंड पॉलिसी, दे हैव वन पोस्ट काइंड ऑफ अ पोस्ट, सो टू बी रिक्रूटेड इन दैट यू मस्ट हैव अ एम एड और एम ए एजुकेशन, यू मस्ट हैव क्लियर द नेट, ठीक है, एंड यू मस्ट हैव अ एम फिल और पी एच डी डिग्री इन द कैरिकुलम डेवलपमेंट एजुकेशनल पॉलिसी और कंप्लीटेड रिसर्च प्रोजेक्ट। ये इसलिए होता है बिकॉज वी डोंट हैव अ एम एड इन कैरिकुलम और द रिसर्च एंड अ पॉलिसी, सो दैट्स वाई दे हैव अ डिजायरेबल क्वालिफिकेशन लाइक दैट यू मस्ट हैव कंप्लीटेड अ रिसर्च इन दैट एरिया, ओके, बिकॉज वी डोंट हैव एम एड विथ दैट स्पेशलाइजेशन, ऑल यूनिवर्सिटी डोंट हैव, सम ऑफ द यूनिवर्सिटी दे आर हैविंग, ओके। So, this is the one of the criteria for being recruited in that area. If you want to be a faculty in mathematics education, so you must have a MA, MEd and a MSc in mathematics like that. If you want to be a faculty in the elementary education, so you must be MA, MEd, NET in education with the स्पेशलाइजेशन इन एलिमेंट्री एजुकेशन, है ना, ऐसे करके अलग अलग स्पेशलाइजेशन होता है। सो इफ यू वॉन्ट टू गो इन द एनसीईआरटी, दिस काइंड ऑफ अ क्वालिफिकेशन इज रिक्वायर्ड, एंड वेन यू विल बी अपॉइंटेड एज अ फैकल्टी देयर, सो टाइम टू टाइम गवर्नमेंट आस्क फॉर द सजेशन, बिकॉज एनसीईआरटी इज द एजेंसी टू सजेस्ट फॉर द स्कूल एजुकेशन, दे यूज टू सजेस्ट, है ना, सो दे विल आस्क लाइक दैट व्हेन द न्यू एजुकेशन पॉलिसी वॉज बींग फ्रेम्ड, द सजेशन इज वेंट फ्रॉम द एनसीईआरटी ऑल्सो, सो इट विल केम, यू हैव टू गिव द सजेशंस, ओके, सो दिस शुड बी इंक्लूडेड एंड इट विल गो टू द कमिटी, दोज वर लाइक दैट व्हेन आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट द सेकेंडरी एजुकेशन कमिटी, सो चेयरपर्सन वॉज लक्ष्मी स्वामी मुद्दरायर एंड देर वेर 4-5 पीपल, सो इट विल गो टू देम, दे विल एग्जामिन द प्रैक्टिकल आस्पेक्ट ऑफ योर सजेशन एंड इफ इट इज अ गुड इनफ इट विल बी एक्सेप्टेड एंड इट विल बी पार्ट ऑफ द पॉलिसी, सो दे आर इन्वॉल्व इन द पॉलिसी फ्रेमिंग, दे आर इन्वॉल्व इन द टीचिंग, दे आर इन्वॉल्व इन द रिसर्च, दे आर इन्वॉल्व इन द extension activities as well, and whatever they are suggesting it is based upon the research, like that the BEd earlier was of 1 year, they have undertaken to organize BEd for 2 year, theek hai, first NCERT was running 2 year BEd and they have outlined the benefit of the 2 year BEd and they have suggested the government, so government also appraise the initiative, they also identify that what is the clear cut difference and they have incorporated in the policy that in the country 2 year BEd will be there, so people are from me and you, people are from this society, they are not coming from the Mars, only the thing is that they are the employee of the NCERT, even it is not like that the only NCERT employee are deciding all the things, when you will find the committee who were in the committee of new education policy, theek hai, you will find that the people from the diverse area were there, okay, so aisa nahi hai ki if you are working in some other university or some other organization you will not get opportunity, you will also get opportunity to contribute, but the thing is that you must have a that kind of a reputation, you must have grown up, you must have shown your credibility, है ना, थोड़ा आप में कुछ तो स्पेशल होना होगा ना, देन द पीपल विल कॉल यू ना, ऐसे ही रहने से पीपल विल नॉट कॉल. इफ यू हैव अ नॉलेज एंड ऑल दोस थिंग द पीपल विल कॉल यू. ठीक है, इवन दोज हु आर इन द एनसीईआरटी, इफ यू विल नॉट वर्क सीरियसली, इफ यू हैव नॉट अ सीरियस कंट्रीब्यूशन टू द डोमेन, पीपल विल नॉट टेक योर सजेशन सीरियसली एंड इट मे नॉट बी अ पार्ट ऑफ द पॉलिसी. Because ultimately, whatever you are suggesting, that must be justifiable with the research evidences. Okay, Suryakant, I think I have talked much more than you were expecting. Okay,
Oman. Thank you, sir.
Message is also there. Message is. Acha, thank you. Message. Man. Okay. Any other question? No question. Achha. I am seeing the watch. Actually, now we have 4 to 5 minutes. Shall we start something? Because it will be not completed if I will start. Because I was thinking of starting the aim of education, secondary education. Somehow it will be not possible to complete that. So that's why I am leaving you here only, and in the next class we will see about the aim and objective of secondary education as emphasized in the Secondary Education Commission 1952-53. Okay,
sir.
Ha, yes, Chinmay.
Sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir. Sir, you said about rote memory something. That in the secondary rote method. Sir, is that in secondary education commission, is that applicable or they were against that rote method?
Obviously, obviously they are against, because when I was talking that you must have noticed that they have identified those area, 5 4 5 areas I have talked, that needs a immediate attention. Why it needs? Because it is not desirable rote learning, rote method of assessment is not desirable. Meaningful learning is a desirable.
But sir, nowadays also it is also applicable, na, rote method.
Nowadays it is also
sir,
there.
Simply, for example, we are.
बोलिए.
यस सर, वी आर गिविंग द एग्जाम ऑन द ऑल द क्वेश्चंस आर कमिंग दैट एज लॉन्ग क्वेश्चन, सो सर दैट इज आल्सो
सेकेंडरी एजुकेशन में ऑल क्वेश्चंस आर लॉन्ग क्वेश्चन ना? नहीं, कहाँ, किस सेकेंडरी बोर्ड में ऐसा होता है? हाँ, सेकेंडरी बोर्ड में कहाँ है लॉन्ग क्वेश्चन? ना ना ना,
सेकेंडरी पे ऑब्जेक्टिव सब्जेक्टिव मिल के आता है.
मतलब देयर इज एम्फेसिस ऑन एवरीथिंग, देयर विल बी ऑब्जेक्टिव पार्ट आल्सो, देयर विल बी सब्जेक्टिव पार्ट आल्सो, देयर विल बी स्कोप ऑफ अ प्रैक्टिकल एग्जामिनेशन आल्सो, देयर विल बी स्कोप फॉर द फॉर्मेटिव एंड समेटिव असेसमेंट आल्सो, है ना? ऑल थिंग्स आर देयर. इफ वन थिंग इज ओनली एम्फेसाइज्ड like that, the earlier only subjective question was the part of the assessment, then it is a bad and it is a undesirable. Okay, Sonali, nowadays that practice is not there to best of my knowledge. Thank you for being with me. Have a nice day.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.